Hello everybody, and we're about to continue our Let's Play series of Dark Souls 3. In our last episode, we worked our way through Half-Light, Spear of the Church, and now we're making our way on toward, I believe, Filianor. So we're going to go up these stairs. And take in the view, because it's probably tremendous. I mean, that is just stunning. The Ring City was something to behold, for sure. Okay, let's hop on in. I think she's been there a very long time. Wow, tremendous. Now that shell or egg of some kind is now cracked. She's very decrepit. It's like she was suspended in time almost, it seems. Can't go that way anymore. And everything is a barren, ashen wasteland. Okay, first we're gonna go this way, I believe.
I've searched for thee, dark, stricken creature. I am Shira. Ascend into the darkness and trust to the flame. At once, I am the banner of the light, the glory of the fire, and the fear of the dark. Thou shalt not be punished for thy treachery, thy profanity, and thy shameless yearning.
Thank you.
Hela, forgive thy lowly kind.
Crucifix of the Mad King. So Shira, essentially, she was kind of upset that we disturbed Filianor's resting spot, and she did not like that. Because that was her whole point, was to make sure that nobody disturbed Filianor's resting spot. I do believe. Now we have the Mad King's... Let's see, what is that called again? Crucifix of the Mad King. A cross spear hung with a malformed corpse. Once a Mad King was born to the pygmy royalty, and Shira, knight of Filianor, put him to rest. But Shira's cross spear, unable to kill the undying king, only pinned itself to him. Ooh, boy. That's intense. Shira delivered them together to a dark room where she stayed and held them close. One of the few weapons in the game with dark damage, actually. Okay, we're gonna head on back real quick and reset everything. One of the pygmies. It's a long way to drag yourself, but for good reason. All the pygmy lords. And good old Gael.
Thank you.
Oh, wow. Okay, so that was our first ever attempt at Gael. Definitely gonna be an interesting fight. Our damage was not super high. I'm gonna try a couple things here. So instead of this, let's throw on our staff on our right hand. Because I feel like we're gonna need our shield available for this fight. And I wonder how fast Dark Edge is, actually. It's not that bad. Okay. Let's try that out. Nope, wrong way. Probably also gonna want the Divine Blessing on there. Even throw a Hidden Blessing on there. And a Synchro. Okay, right from the beginning. Looks like he's gonna meet us. Goodness. Okay, that's doing some damage. Let's try the same thing with our Chaos Blade. And we'll start off with Great Soul Dregs. Might be able to get that in with some affinity. Be a good one, I think. Already tell. Okay, I wonder if that wasn't doing too bad. I'll try it one more time with our Chaos Blade. Our Chaos Infused weapon. It's got some tracking on it. About halfway, I think. Second phase is going to be pretty intense. I'm actually wondering if that is magic. So maybe we want the crush shield on? Or if that's fire. I'm not exactly sure what that red blood magic he's doing. And instead of the dark, let's throw on the bleed and see if we can bleed him. Okay, we actually also might want to switch out and get more Estus. Kind of like with Madeir. I feel like we're not using a lot of magic anyway. Though I do wonder if he is weaker to fire. That might be something to consider. Because the Dark or Great Soul Dregs didn't do too much, actually.
Just wasn't neat.
Okay, let's allot Estus. Let's try that.
Pretty big.
Phase 1 was manageable, I found, after a couple of tries. Phase 2 looks like a whole different experience, though. Okay, we'll start. Oh, we're gonna do. Let's throw our staff back on our left hand. We'll actually start with Frozen Weapon and see if that works. Because then we have Bleed, Physical Damage, and Frost Buildup. Okay, let's give it a try. Back. phase three. On that one. We just ran out of health, I think. Our damage is not great, but I think we'll actually go full Estus. We're definitely getting closer. Sadly, I think we're out of Seagrow. Kind of a bummer.
Just what neat. Pretty.
Here we go. Yeah, we're not really casting, so we don't really need that. Increase HP with each Estus flask. That might be good. Let's give that a try. Get a little more health that way. Okay, let's get back in. It's an amazing fight, though. What a job they did with this one. You have to, like, play really focused. Do get a free shot though, okay. job. That one wasn't as good as our last attempt. Back in though. I wonder if this will take a couple of episodes. Sloppy.
Here we go. quite the reach on that one. Not too bad on that one. Definitely getting closer. Okay, I think we'll actually throw our staff on and maybe fight him from a distance for part of this. Maybe for the ending. That on there right now. Okay. Let's give another try. Such a great fight, though. Thank you. We've got 1 to 2 more tries to get into this episode. We're right over 15 minutes now. Okay, so magic didn't do too much. Let's actually try Tune Spell. Let's actually throw on... Chaos Bad Vestiges, see if that does anything. That is Slave Knight Gael. Wow. That is an amazing fight. Prisoner of the moment, of course, but that's probably the best fight of the game. Wow. Just amazing. There's just so much to keep track of. Of course, all the pygmies. Truly stunning. Whew. Well, I think in our next episode we'll actually just check out all the descriptions for this, for the Slave Knight Gael stuff, like his soul and his weapon and everything. So first, what we're gonna want to do is just head on over to. We gotta get our way on over to here. And talk to the little painter. Before we do that, we should probably read Blood of the Dark Soul. Blood of the Dark Soul that seeped from the hole within Slave Knight Gael, used as pigment by his lady in Ariandel to depict a painted world. When Gael came upon the Pygmy Lords, he discovered that their blood had long ago dried, so consumed the Dark Soul. So intense.
My thanks, Ashen One. With this will I paint a world. Please tell me thy name. I would name this painting after thee. My thanks. I will paint a world of that name. It will be a cold, dark, and very gentle place. And one day, it will make someone a goodly home. I wonder when Uncle Gael intends his return. I hope the new painting will be to him a gentle home. My thanks, Ashen One. I will assuredly finish the painting of a cold one day.
Okay, I think that will do it. I'd like to thank everybody for tuning in, and we'll be talking again real soon.